Well, Queensland's top cop has made an extraordinary admission this week, saying the state can't, quote, arrest its way out of the crime crisis. As violence spirals out of control, Police Commissioner Katerina Carroll says it's up to the courts, the laws and all parts of society to address the problem. Queenslanders don't want to play the blame game. They just want to feel safe, including our next guest, Paralympian Carney Liddell, who's been targeted a second time in less than a year, a heartless thief stealing her mobility trike. She joins us from Brisbane. Carney, good morning to you. I'm sorry you're going through all of this. You say the thief stole your independence. You okay?
yeah, a thief, a white, I've seen him on CCTV. A white, I would say, mid-20s guy came in into our secure car park, Saturday night on a skateboard, and cut through with a grinder, whatever you call it, my bolt-proof safe lock. There are a lot of other normal bikes down there, normal as in specialised, you know, good brands of bikes, but he chose, for some reason, my electric trike. I mean, I think trikes are cool, but they aren't cool amongst the young community. They certainly aren't resellable. And without a key, it would have been a really hard way to get that really heavy trike out. I need that trike because obviously I can't ride a bike. I also can't get around this area of Kangaroo Point because it's so hilly. Yeah. That's why I have an electric trike. And he put it in the lift here, which I can't even believe it fit, and then took it out the front. So again, just like the people, the kids that stole my wheelchair accessible vehicle with my wheelchair in it and a wheelchair hoist, and those kids put their hands on this heavy wheelchair, which is like 35, 40 kilos in an awkward lift when they stole my wheelchair car and threw it on the road. Those sort of criminals and those sort of kids, and I'm a social worker, I have so much empathy, and I'm also in the really pointy end of social work with domestic and family violence, homicides and perpetrators at the very pointy end, is that we need to look at these kids now. We need to look at those sort of kids that put their hands on wheelchairs and know it's a wheelchair and throw it on the road or steal someone's mobility electric trike, which isn't resellable. It's not something that's cool. They're just going to trash it, just like they trash my wheelchair and wheelchair car.
So is what
we don't look at these kids...
Sorry, I'm just asking, is what you're saying,
yep,
we certainly need to stop it, right? And you've been grossly inconvenienced and you've had your personal infringements, obviously made public now. That's tough for you.
Yeah. It's really, really hard. I don't want to be called unlucky. I don't want to be talking about this. I do feel unsafe. I feel violated. I don't think I can keep my wheelchair safe in my car. I don't, and if I lose my wheelchair again, these wheelchairs, not only are they really expensive, they take OT reports and, you know, try and get an OT right now. They take NDIS reports, they take fighting, they take insurance claims. And I was also flooded last year. So I've literally feel like I've filled out every possible form in the world, and I don't think, I haven't got it in me to do it again. I won't be getting another trike because I don't have it in me to even fill out a form. I don't have it in me to fight the NDIS and prove that I'm disabled. But what I really want to do, because I guess I'm in the area of DV and social work, is I don't want this kid to go to the courts and then charge him with stealing a bike, just like he shouldn't have been charged with stealing a car. They need to be charged with stealing wheelchairs, and they need to be charged with stealing wheelchair hoists and independence, and also wheelchair trikes. So that way we can look at those kids properly, because I think I'll be meeting them later on down the track. Mm. I think they'll be our really bad criminals. And if we don't start wrapping interventions and supports and stop just letting them off on probation because they're kids, and I don't want to name and shame these people, I actually want to figure it out.
Mm.
Because there's 70 plus cars being stolen a day in Brisbane.